There are a whole lot of things flat earthers don't understand, but there are a few things that flat earthers don't understand, but those you can understand that flat earthers don't understand. One of them is spherical axis, the fact that angles of a spherical triangle don't add up to 180 degrees, but to a larger number. And, most of all, they don't understand that you can measure this spherical axis. They think a surveyor measures the angles between three points along straight lines of sight, so they measure a triangle with straight sides, so the sum of the angles must be 180 degrees. And besides, you can't get an angle from two curved lines. PT194 has demonstrated that you can measure angles between curved lines, and he demonstrated that the sum of those angles can be more than 180 degrees. But the question remains, how could that be measured? Here's the thing. A surveyor doesn't measure three angles of the same triangle, because he measures only horizontal and vertical angles. And horizontal is not the same at each corner point from where he measures the angle to the other two corner points. MC Toon has presented a diagram where he shows the difference between the horizontal and vertical angles measured at one of those three points. There you can see that the angle measured horizontally differs from the angle at the observer's point in the triangle between the three points. It's a fact that the measured horizontal angles between three points on Earth add up to more than 180 degrees. This can be seen at the different measurements that were made all over the world, like in the Ordnance Survey of England of 1750, or the Transcontinental Triangulation and the American Arc of the Parallel of 1900. Why is that? On a flat Earth, it would be impossible to measure the angles of a triangle in a horizontal plane and get a sum other than 180 degrees. The only way you can get angles in a triangle that add up to more than 180 degrees is that you measure each angle from a horizontal plane that differs from the horizontal planes of the other angles. And that is what happens on a sphere. Let's show it with this example. I constructed part of a sphere. Then I chose three random points above that sphere and connected the dots into a triangle. This triangle has angles that add up to 180 degrees. If you project this triangle onto the sphere, you get this. It is already clear that the angles of the spherical triangle each are almost equal or greater than the corresponding angle of the initial triangle. How are these angles measured? They are measured in a horizontal plane. Horizontal is perpendicular to the vertical, and the verticals are not parallel. So the first angle is measured in this horizontal plane. The second in this horizontal plane. And the third one in this horizontal plane. So you measure three angles that do not form a planar triangle, and these angles add up to 185.15 degrees. Because these angles lie in the projection planes of the initial triangle, they are the same as the angles of the spherical triangle. Of course, this situation is exaggerated to make the point clear. In reality, the spherical axis will be less, because the radius of the Earth is much larger than in this model. That's how geodetic surveyors measure angles in the field, and that's why geodetic surveyors have found spherical triangles with angles that add up to more than 180 degrees. They have found spherical axis, And that's why geodetic surveyors have shown that the Earth cannot be flat.